Hello and welcome to Tim's BMW Repairs and Information, where this episode's all about rust. I hate rust. I hate rust with a vengeance. I hate what it does to the car. It's just ghastly. So this episode's in three stages. First of all, where are you likely to get rust on the E31? Secondly, what you can do to stop the rust appearing in those places in the first place. And lastly, what sort of money does it cost to get the car redone to get rid of the rust? I'm in a lucky position to have just had the rust done on the car, doors and arches and this front wing and so on. So I can give you a good lowdown on the price that I paid to have that done. And also my friend Jin on E31 forums of bimforums.co.uk has also had his car redone from the ground up. A fantastic job. And I can tell you the man hours that are involved in doing it. Yeah, don't worry about the gunfire. Yeah, it's the ranges over there. Unfortunately, they're pointing the other way, so we should be okay. Anyway, let's have a look where the rust occurs in the first place. Right, well, let's work from the top downwards. Every E31 owner knows that the sunroof goes rusty. I'm afraid it's inevitable. Now, the problem is these sort of areas here. And you thought, oh, this is no problem at all. I just sort of sand it down, change the seal around it and repaint it. It'll be lovely. No, afraid not. The sunroof is in two layers, as an inner and an outer layer. And unfortunately, the rust occurs between the two layers. And the problem is that it sort of slurps up moisture from the sunroof tray, which is underneath it. And yeah. And then you get bubbles of rust appearing. This one's not too bad. Oh, I ought to get rid of that green stuff. Yeah, there's absolutely nothing you can do about having this happen. Well, obviously, apart from keeping the car in a warm, dry environment. In the UK here, with this car, I'm afraid, yeah, that's absolutely no chance of that. It lives outside all year, snow, hail, and all the rest of it. So I'm afraid the sunroof is going to go rusty. Now, my previous E31, I was very lucky to find a sunroof which was exactly the same colour, Estoril blue. Orient blue it was, yeah. And that cost me 50 quid and I just swapped them over. It was simple as that. Finding one in Mora metallic, yeah, that's never going to happen. And also the sunroofs that would be around these days be in exactly the same position, have lumps of rust appearing. Yeah, that's a shame that is. So really isn't much you can do about that. Right, working down is the windows, so front and rear windows. Yep, I mean, you've got a choice here, really. Now, the problem is that the windows, they delaminate to start with. Yeah, this one's delaminating here. That means that I've lost half of my defroster elements, which is a bit of a nuisance, but it doesn't bother me that much. And it doesn't bother me to the extent that I want to change the window. And there's a good reason why. When glass is being changed on these cars, it's inevitable that they'll scratch the bodywork as they do it in areas which you can't get to ever again. Well, unless you remove the window again. And then you get rust in places like the corners here. And it is nigh on impossible to sort that out. It really is. You know, imagine getting rust down there. And it sort of blooms out around here. It's not good. So anywhere around the window, if the window's been replaced, then yeah, you've really got to be careful. You've got to make sure when the bloke's doing the glass that he's actually touching up the areas which he's damaged. The TIS says about changing windows that there's got to be a special BMW tool to get the window out in the first place, and that any damage is touched up. It's the same, I'm afraid, for the front windscreen, and these do get broken, obviously, by stone chips and stuff like that. So, yeah, again, if the window's been changed, then, yeah, make absolutely sure that the fitter, as he does it, paints over any scratches to bare metal, because that is hiding to pain, that is. So as soon as it starts going rusty, there's no stopping it at all. And these sort of areas, that's where it appears. That's impossible to fix. I'm afraid the only fix for that is to remove the glass again. And yeah, get the angle grinder out, add metal and all the rest of it. So yeah, horrible thing. So my front window is pitted something awful and the rear window is delaminating, but I'm going to keep them as they are because I'd much rather have that than having paint rust bloom up everywhere. Okie dokes, we'll work our way down a bit. Yeah, it's a bit of an unusual one this is, but on the very front edge of the bonnet or hood, yeah, that's where you can get rust. I'll show you a picture of someone who's got rust there. Nothing happening here at all, fortunately, all nice and clean. So yeah, all along the front there. So okay, so that's sunroof, windows, bonnet. And then we work down to the usual areas in front, which is the wheel arches. Rear wheel arches, that's the one to go. So this has been repainted twice. So it was repainted when I bought the car, which was 13 years ago. So the respray lasted 13 years. So that's fine with me. And it's all lovely and shiny again. And I can tell you how much that cost a bit later on. So yeah, rear wheel arches, that's the favourite. And then bottom of the wheel arch here, bottom of the door here, that's where the major problems occur, corners of the doors, and I can show you how I can stop that happening in a minute. Middle of the door also happens, and underneath the door as well, when we open the door, the underneath part can go mouldy and rusty. And again here on the sills, and this front of the door here, that's a classic place, I'm afraid. Front wheel arches don't seem to suffer from rust anywhere near as much, but I have seen a few that are rusty, but are yet nowhere near as much as the rear arches. Okay, a few other ones just to put you fully in the picture. Yeah, the boot or trunk, yeah, the lid on that can go rusty. Up here is a classic place to go rusty. And then one bit on mine which has gone slightly rusty, which is right the middle there. And the reason for that is that it's got the drain hole at the bottom of the trunk there. So yeah, it's same with all BMWs. It's this area here which can go rusty. Okay. So I think we've covered the major ones. I mean, individual cars get rust in strange places, but that is the main ones. Right, the next thing is, what can we do to stop it happening? Well, first of all, some things go rusty no matter what you do to them, sunroof being one of them. Right, so let's have a quick look around. Right, if we start with the wheel arches, yes, there is something you can do to stop those going rusty. But unfortunately, it involves a bit of water work and getting your hands right up there. Here's me doing the rear wheel arches. And remove all of that dirt. Yep, when I got this car, they had done one of the arches. The other one, blimey, it was full of mud, it really was. It was no wonder that they're starting to go. So yeah, remove the mud and you have much less problems. You can use a rust proofer in there, something like Dinitrol. I'm not sure what difference that's going to make. It really is a matter of keeping them clean. And when we get to the front arches, of course, the wheel liner in these is much more extensive than the rear ones, and it does tend to protect the inner arch, the inner part of the arch to some extent. But again, you need to get your hand up in there and clean it all out, all the way down to the bottom. Okay, that's wheel arches. Let's move on to the doors. Right, well, doors next. Well, these go rusty in the corners and so on, as I've shown already, but it all starts from the top. Yeah, it's the top seals here. Now, if they let water in, it's going to go to the bottom of the door. Now, there's two drains in the door, and I'll show you those in a minute. But to stop the water getting down the side of the window, then we need to keep in condition the rubber seal, which rubs up against the window. And it's awkward to get to, so you have to drop the window as far as you can. And then you need gummy fledge, bit of gummy fledge, put that on the seal to start lubricating it. So do a little bit at a time and I'll show you what I mean. Now what they do is they build up lichen on the face of them. So once you've got the gummy fledge on them, then you need a microfiber cloth and a trim tool. And with the trim tool, you push it down the edge of the seal. So now you can push against the edge of the seal to rub off any of the lichen. I'll bring you in close at the moment because I have got quite a bit of lichen on here. And so, yeah, I'm glad I'm doing this video. Reminds me to clean the seal. There we go. Right, let's bring you in close. So righty-ho. So there we go. There's the seal. That's the bit I just cleaned. And as you can see, the bits I haven't, it's got lichen on. It's quite tough old stuff as well. Yeah, if we get right in there. So that stops the sort of weather properties of the seal. But as you can see here where I've cleaned it, all back to rubbery loveliness again. So I'll do all of that. Also, don't forget the back windows. They get the lichen on just as much. And the rust's going to end up in down the bottom of the arch there. So yeah, it can rust from both sides. So yeah, don't forget the gummy fledge there as well. Right, there we go. Then so I've done the face of it there where it meets the glass, that's all nice and soft and supple now. And also I did in here, which is the edge of the seal itself, give that a good bit of gummy fledge. And that'll press tightly up against the window now so that the rain won't get past it. Right, let's have a look at these drains. Okay, there's one at the back, one at the front. Here's the one at the back. And you see there's one of the drain holes. It's got that yellow stuff in it, is the anti-corrosion agent I've put into the door. And I'll explain about that at the moment. And there's the lump on the door itself, and that pushes against this seal down here. Now it's fine as long as this is supple, it gets out of the way. If it doesn't, it just encloses the drain hole and stops any moisture coming out of it. So you've got to make sure that seal's nice and supple, and we'll do that, of course, with gummy fledge. So yeah, got one there. And you're not going to see it very well there, are you? You can see the lump, but yeah, the drain is just there. So yeah, it's important to keep the drain holes clear, but also it's a good plan to use a rust inhibitor. So here we've got Stabil Rust Stopper. And fortunately it's got a nice little straw on it that fits right up the hole in the drain holes nicely. So I'll give that a squirt. So there we go, we can do it from both sides. So there's one of the drain holes. And you can see what the problem is here. If the drain hole's blocked, then the water just sits in the bottom of the door in this area, and this goes rusty, and then rust will start appearing from the outside. So a bit of rust stopper in there. Give it a good old squirt. There we go. Yeah, strange how none of it comes back out again, isn't it? There you go. Anyway, the rust stopper will help because it's a water dispersant as well. I mean, WD-40 works for this pretty well, but I thought I'd use a rust inhibitor as well. So we squirted it into the cavity of the door. At some point it will pop out one end or the other, pop out this end when I'm accelerating and that end when I stick the brakes on. Yeah, so that fills up the cavity at the bottom of the door, and hopefully the plan is to stop that going rusty. I'll give it another squirt upwards this time. Yeah, you certainly hear it going in, that's for sure. Now, further to that, this door, I've noticed the paint just slightly crinkly in places. And so what I've done with that, I've removed these bungs here, and I'll show you me doing that in a minute. Got one there and got one further up as well in the door. Take those both out and squirt the anti-corrosion agent into the bottom cavity of the door and also towards the seam, because it's the seam that starts going first. Right, let's get that stopper out of there. They can be awkward little things, they are. They need a good poke inwards and then pull down. There we go, that's off. All in one piece still. There we go, and that's what one of them looks like. It's got the funny sort of crinkly bits. And this bit here obviously has got to go into the door fully, otherwise it's going to fall back out. Righty-o, let's get the rust proofer in there. There we go, straw deployed, stab in, and find the hole. There we go. That's going in. Try and squirt it all the way round so it goes in all of the seams. Good, that would have gone all along the bottom of the door and into the seam here. Right, time for the next one. Let's get to put these back in properly so they click into place. There we go. Okay, so that's about it for doors. So just to reiterate what we went through, clean all the lichen off the seal so the water doesn't get on past the glass and into the bottom cavity in the first place. Make sure both the drain holes are clear. And if you are using the car in all weathers, then yep, use an anti-corrosion agent, squirt it up into the door and along the door. Wouldn't it be better to remove the door card, Tim, and do it properly? No, it won't. First of all, it's a bit of a pain in the neck getting the door card off. And secondly, of course, you've got the vapor barrier in the way, so you have to take the vapor barrier off. And yeah, and we've got to stick it back on again properly, so it is still a vapor barrier. So no, I don't think so. I think it's much easier just squirting the stuff into the bottom of the door. Okay, that's doors. Right, after doors we come to windows, and we've touched on this already. Now, the only way to ensure you're not going to get rust around the windows, and especially these areas which are real killers, is to not replace the glass. Yeah, don't feel in too much of a hurry to have the glass replaced. As I say, I'd much rather put up with a bit of blooming in the glass, delamination, rather than change it. But if you have to change it, and I realise obviously front windscreens can come a cropper, then keep a beady eye on the fitter. Make sure it doesn't scratch any of the areas where the new glass is going to go in. Make sure you get a look at the body before he does it. So if you've got someone come out to do the glass, yeah, just come out and say, yeah, yeah, you've missed a bit there, mate. Yeah, you need a bit of touch up there. It's bare metal. Yeah, because that's the only way you're going to stop these windows coming a cropper. And of course, it doesn't do the window any good either with the rust bubbling up. Yeah, it's horrible. And it's the most important thing to remember is keep a beady eye on the fitter and make sure he touches up all the place and uses a tool that doesn't go around scratching all the edge of the paintwork. There's a BMW special tool for it, and if he hasn't got it, well, tell him to clear off and find someone who does. Okay, so windows. Right, general paintwork, that's really tackled by using a good concentration of triple wax shampoo. So I use a triple wax shampoo, but I use 10 times the concentration, and so I give it a good old wash. Rinse it with rainwater rather than tap water that hasn't got any chlorines in and stuff like that. Leave it a few seconds and then buff it off with a huge microfiber cloth. And that tends to leave the wax in the right areas. And you might think, well, this is one of the very latest E31s, but I've seen one which is later and it's had the boot lip and the front bonnet rust coming in those places. The rest of the car was a complete mess as well. It'd obviously never been cleaned. So yeah, look after your paintwork. And of course I use Zano 2 as the polish. Zano 2 is hard as nails. It's a bit, pus you out a bit, to be honest, to put it on. It's quite a lot of hard work. You put it on and you leave it 15 to 20 minutes and then you buff it off. And it's the buffing off which is hard work, and you wish you only did a bit of the car rather than all of it when you're doing it. That look after your paintwork. So yeah, the paintwork in this car, absolutely perfect. Okay, so we come on to cost. Right, on this car I had rear wheel arches, both of them absolutely knackered, bits of rust hanging off. You didn't really notice it in the videos because more metallic tends to hide it, which I'm very glad about. So yeah, both wheel arches, the doors, the front and the back corners, and a spot in the middle near the bottom. They're obviously caused by the water getting into that area at the bottom of the door, so I'm really glad I've sealed that up now. So both doors, and also he re-lacquered, put the clear coat on the wing, which I'd worked on not very successfully. So that's all looks lovely again now. So the whole car's looking absolutely perfect. £2,000. Yep, had that done in a local garage, and I used him because the car, when it went for an MOT, got damaged there, got a big scratch across the boot lid, and they said they'd fix it for me. I was a bit worried. I said, well, I'm rather take it to BMW, and they said, well, just give us a chance, and they did it, and it looks absolutely perfect. I couldn't see where that scratch was, and the scratch was so deep, actually deformed the metal into a V shape. So fantastic job there. So I was quite happy to let the car go to him and spend his 5 days working on it. And another couple of days for it to dry off completely. Yeah, £2,000, can't complain of that. Of course, £2,000 plus VAT in the UK. So that's the sort of price you're looking for to do this sort of work. And it matches, everything matches perfectly. There's no color differentiation in any of it. So it's really a great job. More metallic is a bit like that though. It does tend to hide any color defects because it looks completely different from one direction to another. Put that against my friend Jin, who did an extensive job, and that was seals as well. Now I didn't mention seals because I don't generally look at them. If it passes the MOT, then the seals, the jacking points are okay, and that usually means the seals are all right. It's underneath, so I ignore it. As long as it passes an MOT, it's fine. Anyway, Jin had his done, complete respray. So he had the seals done, and that meant cutting big lumps out of them, welding lumps of metal back into them. Fantastic job. And then the whole car, and the doors done from the bottom up, bare metal everywhere. Didn't remove the glass because of the same reason that I'll try and avoid removing glass, because of the danger of getting something damaged. Complete respray. He also had his arches rolled at the back, I think, because he wanted to put 305s in there, which don't quite fit, probably something a bit bigger as well. Anyway, that sort of job takes about a month and is 300 man hours. I won't give you the price, I told you I wouldn't, but 300 man hours, and you can work out, if you like, how much that's going to cost you. Yeah, it's not going to be cheap. So we got from £2,000 up to 300 hours. There's a huge difference. Anyway, I think that'll do for rust. I don't like rust, never like rust. Yeah, ghastly stuff. Put the thumbs up if you enjoyed the video and it helped you. Keep the communications coming in. I love the comments, always trying to reply to them as quickly as possible. See you next time.